Influenced by the new wave of British heavy metal and the black metal band Venom, Rob Ferretti, Miller Petroza, and Ventor formed a band and played some gigs locally. After several name changes, the trio recorded the demo End of the World under the name Tormentor, which landed them a contract with the Berlin-based label Noise Records. Now officially known as Creator, the band entered the studio in May to record their debut album, Endless Pain. This release opened the door for the band's music internationally as it began to perform outside of Germany and made their first ever television appearance. Following the release of Creator's second album, Pleasure to Kill, the band hit the road for a world tour, which also took them to the United States and Canada. Joining them now was a second guitarist, Wolf, who was soon replaced. Terrible Certainty led Creator to the next phase of their career, a second world tour, and the group's entry into the music video realm with the clip Toxic Trace.
What direction? Better than the field. As long as there's nothing optimistic going on, we can write about it, you know?
Thank you, Hope.
I'm Tristan, I play the rhythm guitar, creator.
I'm Miller, and I play guitar and try to sing.
I'm Rob, I play bass.
I'm Vento, I play drums.
A new studio album and a video production shot in the Greek Acropolis ruins were completed before the musicians set out for a tour of Europe.
We'll be right back.
However, the hectic work pace and concert touring had its price as guitarist Tripsa was replaced by former SOTA member Frank Blackfire during the Extreme Aggression tour.
The band over here, Mr. Frank Blackfire.
After the Berlin Wall fell in November of 89, Creator became the very first Western heavy metal band to perform in the former East Berlin in front of 6,000 fans. '90 found the band recording the Coma of Souls album in Los Angeles and the Hallucinative Coma's home video. Back in Europe, they appeared at the legendary Roskilde Festival in Denmark before heading to Mexico City.
Welcome to Mexico, and the first question we have is, do you imagine, how big is your name here in Mexico?
What do you mean?
Yeah.
Like how
you're famous in Mexico. Would you imagine that?
Oh, that's really nice to hear.
Eure letzte Veröffentlichung ist ein Video, das in gewisser Hinsicht sehr ungewöhnlich ist, weil es weder ein ganz gewöhnliches Live-Video ist, noch irgendwie so eine Ansammlung von Clips, wie man das sonst so kennt. Wie kam euch die Idee oder von wem ist die Idee überhaupt dazu?
Die ganze Sache basiert auf dem Text von Terror Zone. Bei Terror Zone geht es um Halluzinationen und wie man, also verschiedene Wege, sich in Ekstase zu versetzen.
You're buried in the mud, and when you die,
By the early 90s, Creator was experimenting with alternative styles of metal, and the Renewal album promotion included a video clip of the title track filmed in the desert of Israel. We'll be right back.
the lyrics on the album, in some cases, you seem to have become a lot more politically aware. I was thinking, actually, of Europe After the Rain. Did the problems in your own country sort of cause you to consider these issues now that you'd kind of had first-hand experience of them?
Yeah, I mean, we've always wrote about that, you know, stuff like racism, stuff like, mm-hmm. on People of Lie was a song about racism. And we always try to be as politically aware as possible. Mm-hmm. Since Europe is becoming like one and everything's getting together, mm-hmm. and becoming one nation or whatever. Mm. I think that, especially in this time where there's a lot of changes going on, mm-hmm. a lot of people must change their attitude mm-hmm. towards, you know, mm-hmm. different cultures and all that.
After a groundbreaking tour of Australia, bassist and founding member Rob left the band for a more stable family life.
Metal ist auf keinen Fall eine Musik, die Gewalt befürwortet. Ich finde eher, dass diese Art von Musik vielen Leuten die Möglichkeit gibt, ihre Aggressionen auf positive Art und Weise umzuwandeln. Wir würden uns eigentlich nicht als eine politische Band bezeichnen, sondern mehr eine Band, die politische Positionen vertritt.
Right now, there's some real fucked up things going on back there. The government really sucks, and, you know, fucking racism sucks as well. We should create ourselves. Fuck the fascists, man! Fuck them! There's a song called Europe After the Rain.
Qualität ist eigentlich nicht so ein Qualitätsmerkmal. Es ist die Art, es gehört zu der Musik. Meine Brutalität kommt auch daraus. Wenn ich anderthalb Stunden auf einem Konzert hinterm Schlagzeug gewütet habe, danach bin ich nicht mehr brutal. Meine Aggressionen sind weg, die Brutalität, die war da, die war vorher da, aber die ist dann weg. Und auch wenn ich die Leute im Pit sehe, zum Beispiel die Fans, wenn die da. Also manchmal sieht mir das auch zu brutal aus, aber wenn ich sie dann nach dem Konzert sehe, blutende Nase, gebrochenes Handgelenk, dann stehen sie vor dir, boah, hab ich einen Spaß gehabt. Ich kann meine Hand nicht mehr bewegen jetzt. Ich weiß nicht, was los ist, aber ich hab einen Spaß gehabt.
Continuing on the road with a session player, Creator flew to Moscow for a sellout show to end the renewal tour. Cause for Conflict, the only Creator album not to feature original drummer Ventor, as he took a leave of absence at this time. Milla and Blackfire were joined by Joe Cagliosi and new bassist Christian Giesler for yet another tour around the globe and another video production, Lost, which was filmed in an abandoned German hospital.
Die Platte heißt Cause for Conflict. Der Unterschied zur letzten Platte, Renewal, steht eigentlich darin, dass wir 1992 auf Renewal eigentlich ein bisschen mehr unsere experimentelle Phase ausgelebt haben und auf der neuen wieder zurück in die mehr direkte Art von Musik gehen. Die Platte ist deshalb so aggressiv ausgefallen, weil sich bei Crater in den letzten zwei Jahren viel an Aggression und Wut aufgestaut hat. Es hat damit angefangen, dass wir Probleme mit unserer alten Plattenfirma hatten, dass wir da einen Wechsel vollzogen haben von Noise Records auf Gun Records. Und wir fanden einfach mal wieder, dass es Zeit ist, eine Platte zu machen, die aggressiv klingt und sehr brutal nach vorne geht.
podcasts, new changes and familiar faces, as Vento returned to the fold at the same time as Blackfire left the band, to be replaced by former Coroner guitarist Tommy Fetterly. The Outkast album and tour was highlighted by Creator's manic live show at Holland's Dynamo Festival in front of 30,000 metal fans. Endorama signaled the end of the 90s and the most melodic of all Creator albums, dividing the opinions of fans and supporters. The title track featured a duet between Milla and Lacrimosa's Tilo Wolf in the video clip, while the song The Chosen Few was used in a German film soundtrack.
Follow my friends,
Endorama's
salvation, my sacrilege, my inner sanctum and prophecy. You become everything and more to me. So our souls will be one. A new era has begun. Fantasies will come true.
Violent Revolution. Creator's first album of the new millennium saw a return to the classic sound that everyone was waiting for. Joining the band was new guitarist Sami from the Finnish group Valtari.
Willkommen aus Essen, wie einige von euch vielleicht wissen. Schon lange her, dass wir das letzte Mal hier gespielt haben. Und wie ist die Stimmung?
The Violent Revolution World Tour took the band to 28 countries and over 120 shows, their longest tour ever, winding up in their hometown of Essen, Germany, to a crowd of 15,000 fans.
Society failed to tolerate me.
Another curse, another doom.